Hello friends, welcome to the world of Lean Six Sigma. Hi, I am Mohit Sharma. I am your mentor and coach on Lean Six Sigma issues and problems. Today I am going to talk about a very important tool, which is failure mode and effect analysis. FMEA is a Six Sigma methodology tool, but it can be used by Lean practitioners or project managers as well. They can identify and understand their project problems with the help of this tool. FMEA is a highly systematic approach to identify and understand potential failure modes in any system. It tracks back to 1940s, but it is as valuable today as it was then. To understand it in a better way, let us take an example. Rather, I'll take two examples, one from manufacturing industry and the other one from the service industry to help you understand this better. In manufacturing industry, we will take the example of brakes in the car, and in the service industry, we will take the example of report preparation in financial reporting process. So let's begin.
So let us take the first example where I said brakes in a car could be a failure mode. This is the FMEA template which can be used to fill the details. First is the process function. Braking system is the process function. The potential failure mode here is the brake. The potential effect of the failure could be an accident. The severity of this is 10. So you can refer this scale. You can refer to this scale in which injury to a customer or an employee, the severity scale is 10. The potential cause of the failure is that it could be the brake oil that has leaked. The occurrence is, again you can refer back to the scale where it says if it is happening once per week for the cars that we are manufacturing, it means the rating score is 8. The current process control, there is a brake oil indicator on the car dashboard. So detection score is inversely proportional. The lower the detection, the higher the score. We can detect that brake fail can happen by looking at the brake oil indicator, but it will not prevent us from starting the car and taking the car on the road. So hence, it is not a foolproof detection. So the detection score is high in this case, which is 6. You can again refer back to the same scale. Then we calculate the RPN score, which is the risk priority number score, which is multiplication of 10 into 8 into 6. 10 into 8 into 6 gives us an RPN score of 480. The recommended action is the periodic service of the car. The responsibility lies with the car owner that they have to take the car to the service stations every time. The actions that have been taken are they have pasted the sticker of the next service date in the car, and they start making calls to remind the user about the service schedule. So these are the actions that the company has started taking. The new severity score remains the same, because if the car accident happens because of the brake failure, even though we have provided certain mitigations, still the severity remains the same. Occurrence has gone down to 2 in this case, and detection has gone up, hence the score has gone down. So the 4 score is given. So overall score is 10 into 2 into 4, which is 80. So in failure mode and effect analysis, this RPN score should be less than 100 to say that the failure is under control. So in this case, the failure is under control. Let us go to the second example. The second example is of a report generation process which helps a financial organization to publish their numbers to the street. So the process function here is report generation process. So potential failure mode is wrong data used to prepare financials. And the effect of the failure is that wrong numbers are reported to the street. The severity of that can be checked in the rating scale. In this case, it would be illegal, and severity scale of 9 is given. Potential cause or the mechanism of failure is the wrong data is because of the manual error during report preparation. The occurrence is 7 because it is high in number, happening many times. This kind of activity happens every month, and every time they are producing the wrong report or wrong data. Hence, an occurrence scale of 7. Current potential control is manual check before the release is what they are doing at the moment. And if we look at the detection score, which is process is monitored and manually inspected, which has a rating scale of 5. Total RPN score, which is multiplication of severity, occurrence and detection, is 315 in this case. The recommended action is that we need to create a macro to fetch the report from Oracle database directly. No manual intervention. Responsibility is of the IT manager. And the action taken is that the macro has been created and tested for verified results. So the new RPN score is 9, which is way less than 100. Hence, this failure mode is mitigated. So friends, this is how you can identify the failure modes their severity, occurrence and detection. Then you can identify the RPN score and finally create a recommended action which can help you solve the problem. This is how the FMEA is used in services as well as in manufacturing industry. So friends, if you like this video, please give it a thumbs up and share this video with your friends. I'll see you in my next upcoming video. Till then, take care. Bye-bye.